Sri Lanka preserved the tradition for many years, and from Sri Lanka, the direct spoken word of the Buddha that was preserved since shortly after the passing of the Buddha, there was the first Buddhist council. And this is when the teachings of the Buddha were recorded and were recited so that they would be remembered correctly. And the tradition carried on and moved to Burma, where the sixth Buddhist council ended up taking place in the 1950s. And Mahasi Sayadaw, one of the late Venerable Mahasi Sayadaw, one of the great teachers from Burma, played a very important role in that sixth Buddhist council, which again recognized and recorded the teachings of the Buddha as they have been preserved for the past 2,500 years. And during that sixth Buddhist council, the Venerable Mahasi Sayadaw served as the final editor as well as the chief inquisitor, so the one that would refine some of the points both that are stated in the original scriptures and in some of the commentaries that have been preserved. One of the amazing outcomes from that sixth Buddhist council, in addition to preserving the teachings in the form that has been passed down for generations, was that the Mingun Sayadaw was actually recognized for his ability to recollect the entire Buddhist Pali Canon, more than 16,000 pages, and it was recorded in the Guinness Book of World Record. So it was a rather extraordinary event where there was both somebody who was living at the time who had full recollection of all the teachings of the Buddha, and these were recorded and preserved and can be found in Rangoon to this day in many languages, including Nepalese and even Tibetan. So after the Mahasi Sayadaw was not only a great scholar, but he was intrigued by what he studied in his youth, and he was a very good scholar. And he went and sought out a great meditation teacher of the time to put the practice that he had read about and experience it for himself. And his realization is what it was, and he brought from the forests of Burma a practical method that had been preserved by monks for generations, and he started to make it accessible to lay people. And he encouraged his family and those that were close to him to come to the center and to put the teachings of Satipatthana Vipassana, or extraordinary mindfulness, into practice so that they could realize the teachings of the Buddha for themselves. So Sayadaw Upandita was a very close disciple of Mahasi Sayadaw and actually ran the Mahasi Center after the late Venerable Mahasi Sayadaw passed away. But Sayadaw has been very committed to his work with Western students over the course of many decades at this point, and he wanted to create a center where Westerners could come and study the teachings of the Buddha, both from a theoretical and a practical aspect. So I think one of the Sayadaw's amazing capabilities is his ability to share the authentic scriptures in a very practical way that we can experience for ourselves. And he's also able to take what our common everyday experiences are and explain them in the context of the Buddhist teaching. So we're very fortunate today that Sayadaw is able to come and share with us his teachings. And with that, I would also like to mention that our translator for today is a venerable monk from Germany who has been a student of Sayadawji's for many years. He has been a Theravada Buddhist monk for 20 years now. And he lives in Lumbini, and he runs the Pandita Rama Lumbini Meditation Center. So with that, I would like to invite the Venerable Sayadaw to please share the Dhamma with us.
Is it time now?
Yeah, a cool mama.
Huyumiyaku, Dithanaku, Yoshi Viro, ရှင်မျိုးထထတည်နေတွေ့ရတာဝန်တာပါတယ်ဒီဌာနရောက်ဖို့ဆိုတာဘုံညာဟောတော့မမျှော်လင့်ခဲ့ပါဘူးမဟိန္ဒခေါ်တဲ့အင်ဂျူးကပေါ်တယ်သူကရှောက်ထားလို့သူကိုယ်တိုင်လည်းပဲလာရောက်ပြီးတော့သူရှောက်ထားတဲ့နေမို့လို့သူ့ဆန္ဒလည်းဖြည့်ရင်ကျောင်းအားလျော်စွာပါလေသူ့ဆန္ဒဖြည့်ရနေပြီးတော့တရားဖို့ကိုယ်တွေကိုလည်းပဲ
So the venerable Sayadaw has certainly come to this certain place, and he is certainly meeting with all of you, and certainly we are related to one another in many different ways. Previously, the venerable Sayadaw had certainly no thought whatsoever to come to this very institute. It is upon the special request by Andrew, his Dhamma name being Mahinda, that Satna, the Venerable, has Satna conceded to or consented to it, and it is Satna thus fulfilling Andrew's Satna desire. And the Venerable Sayadaw is Satna very glad and pleased about this.
อาชาไตตาริเนี่ยตรงๆๆปาริบาละอินเดียอนวยริเนี่ยตรงๆๆชื่อบาละพี่รออูยอกไตตาริอเมริกาไตตาริอัฟริกาไตตาริก็ปามาบารอไม่ได้บาวพี่รูอาชาไตตาริสออาชาทวีสัตว์นี่ล่ะอาชาเรลีทีฟซะบาละแต่ส่วนนี้ดิบากะบาลงนี้บ่มา ดูดาอาชีพเนี่ยบ่ดิยีเจ้ผู้ฤาษาสกาก้วยนี่ไปมั้ยลูกดูดาชีพก็ดูๆเว้ยทีเราก็บะสุยမျိုးดิรู้แล้วไปสุ่นไหนมาเลยโลกสุยမျိုးกบะสุยမျိုးบ่ดิผู้นี้พุทธอโลยะชื่อๆตัวบ่มีสวากะไม่มีไม่ตั่วเนี่ยอ๋อผิดเข้าจักบาดะ ไอ้ที่บัวบ้องเนี่ยสว่ามาอาชีพเนี่ยตามีจริงต่อดานี่กุมนบาจริงต่อดาพี่รอตะวินกวยจริงต่อดาบ่นี่สุญญูฤทธิ์ต่อสักแค่จ้ะแล้วสุญญูอิงฉะฤทธิ์เว้ยสุญญูห้องฤทธิ์เว้ยสังสาระฤทธิ์ขอว่าได้ตะมาสุญญูห้องฤทธิ์เว้ยโลกอันเดียวเพียงอาชาสุญญูกบะสุญญูสังสาระสุญญูฤทธิ์บ่เว้ย
When assessing our audience here this afternoon, the Venerable Sayadaw has come to see that there are quite a number of Asians sitting here. There are also quite a number of people of Indian descent. Some Europeans are there, some from America, and whether people from Africa are present here or not, the Venerable cannot or does not know exactly. Now, since there are a number of Asians here, we are, and he himself is from an Asian country, we are Asian relatives. We live on the same continent. Now, since we are all human beings, though we may be speaking different languages, coming from different certain cultures, yet one thing joins us, one thing connects us, namely that we all live on the same globe, and as such we can be referred to as or we're related as global relatives. To put it differently, we are loka relatives, so relatives in the same world. Now, the Buddha has Satna mentioned in the text Satna that in previous existences, all of us here have been related in one way or another, namely related as mother and son, father and daughter, brother and sister, and first generation, second generation, and so on. So in this way, we are related in different ways. From a worldly perspective, we are old relatives, we're Asian relatives. As we live in the same world, we are local relatives or global relatives, and in particular, we are relatives in samsara. Now the fact that we have all come together here in this place, namely out of an interest in the Dhamma, is then evidence that we are not only relatives in this world, in this loka, but we are also Dhamma relatives. And the Venerable would like to confirm this.
Loka Swimyo, Sansara Swimyo, Swimyo don't
Now, according to what has been said so far, we are related as Asians, and therefore we are Asian relatives. We are also relatives in this world. We're furthermore related in the course of samsara, and above of this, on top of this, we are related in the Dhamma. So we're related in at least four ways. If the Venerable Sayadaw or the Venerable Sayadaw stating things in this way, would you, the audience, accept it? Could you approve of this? Is this correct or not? Do you agree that we are related in four ways? Yes? And even though we might not be related, yet at least we are related as Dhamma relatives.
By force, probably.
But by force.
You know, Dhamma Swamyo Dosa De Pogoreo. မင်းသားကတရားပြီးတော့တရားဟောကြားဖို့ရပါလိမ့်လျှောက်ထားတော့သူတို့လည်းထိုက်တန်တဲ့တရားဘာများဟောရပါမလဲလို့စဉ်းစားတဲ့အခါမှာဓမ္မဆွေမျိုးဆိုတော့ဓမ္မသွေးဘယ်လောက်အထိရည်ကျက်နေပါလဲရည်ကျက်နေတဲ့ဓမ္မသွေးဟာလည်းပဲဘယ်လောက်တိုင်တာအထိလက်ပတ်လုံးကောင်းနေပါလဲဆိုတာပေါ့လေ
ဒီတော့ဓမ္မဆိုတာဘာလဲဘယ်လိုလဲပေါ့လေဘယ်လိုအနေထားနဲ့နေတဲ့ပုဂ္ဂိုလ်သာဓမ္မဝိဟာရီလို့ဆိုရတယ်ဆိုတာပေါ့လေအဲ့ဒီကောင်းစဉ်လေးတွေနဲ့ဆွေမျိုးတွေကိုဘုန်းကြီးဓမ္မလက်ဆောင်ဗုဒ္ဓအလိုရာပေးပါမယ် Now, it is upon the request by Andrew and his Dhamma name being Mahinda that we are here and we as Dhamma-related people are here. So this being the case, the Venerable Sayadaw then reflected on what kind of Dhamma talk, what kind of topic would be suitable for this occasion. And one of the questions then came up, how mature is this Dhamma blood? And questions such as, what is the Dhamma, how is it practiced, and what kind of people can be or could be considered as Dhamma Viharis. So today, the Venerable Sayadaw would like to offer a gift of Dhamma to all of you in line with the Buddha's teachings.
ဒီတော့ဘုရားတို့ဆွေမျိုးတွေကိုဓမ္မအကြောင်းခွင့်ရဟောပြနေပါတယ်ဆိုတော့ကောပြတဲ့အနေမျိုးမဟုတ်ဆွဲနေပါလိဓမ္မဆွေမျိုးတွေဘယ်တော့အတိုင်းဓာတ်ထိပါလိဓမ္မဆိုတာဘာလဲဘယ်လိုလဲဓမ္မဝိဟာရီအဆင့်ဘယ်တော့အတိုင်းဓာတ်ရောက်နေပါလဲဆိုတာဆွေးနွေးဟန်နဲ့ခွင့်ရကိုတည်တော်တည်
Now, as certain the Buddhists, as certain the Venerable Sayadaw Pandita, certain relatives, he would certainly like to discuss with you questions such as, what is the Dhamma? What is a Dhamma Vihari? So please do not take this event as the Venerable Sayadaw giving a Dhamma talk, but rather perceive it as an exchange, as a Dhamma discussion.
ဒီပုဂ္ဂိုလ်ရတော့ထင်ရင်လည်းထင်ပါပဲမိမိတို့လည်းပဲဓမ္မကြည့်နေတာပဲဓမ္မလမ်းကြောင်းလိုက်နေတာပဲဓမ္မအကြောင်းလာပြီးတော့ဟောနေတာလိုအပ်သလားဆိုတော့ဘာလဲအဲ့ဒါလည်းထင်ရင်လည်းထင်ကြပါပဲဒါတော့အဲ့ဒီအထင်တွေလည်းပဲပျောက်သွားအောင်ဆိုပြီးတော့ဓမ္မဆွေမျိုးချင်းဓမ္မ
Now, some of you might certainly think, well, I'm already engaging in, or I'm already following the Dhamma path. Why should I, why would certainly the Venerable Sayadaw talk about certainly the Dhamma? And so, in order for the Venerable Sayadaw to be free from a transgression, he, and also for the purpose of straight forwardness, he would rather take it as, or therefore he prefers to do this in the form of a discussion, and this he would like to state prior to proceeding.
ဘုရားကြီးရဲ့မေကွန်း 300 ထဲမှာဒ
Out of the three questions Sadhana asked, the Venerable will deal first Sadhana with the question, what is Dhamma? In the text, we find the following definition, namely in the Pali scripture language, Atanam Dharente Chatusu Apayesu Vata Dukkesu Cha Apatamani Katawa Dharehetiti Dhammo. Now, in short, this the meaning of this Pali definition is to protect one from falling into states of loss and thereby being uplifted. This is called Dhamma in the Pali scripture language and in Sanskrit Dharma.
Dhamma ko chi saung du so ra ga yata nu sei da paripet chan de lo di lo phwin da ba de nyu ja di tai buddha myat so ma karuna lo chi tha pi lo tu ko dai mo le ti tha de tia de ko kho cha tha ba de Tonton Tavare, Ni Vi Tavare, Jizori, who shone Ni Jingong, shouted Nidhi Wadi Dama, Lamane, Lama Wadi, at a pure Tavare. That is New Jari at I Jintone Poku, Mialu, Gilu Tibi Yavare, at our Tia, Jinsong, who looks over there.
Now, in practicing the Dhamma, there are practicing the Dhamma which the Buddha delivered, which he taught us out of great compassion, Mahakaruna, and that he discovered for himself. In the end, or simply put, is to avoid any form of unskillful path or practice and to engage in skillful, wholesome practice. Such a person who practices in this way is known as a bearer of the Dhamma.
เอราวเนเนตู้เฉ่เปียวอะลุชิยะเนาะที่จินนี้อปันปะปุจเจติธรรมมาลาได้อไตบ่อลิติจิตส่องตู้
Now, to elaborate on this point a bit more, a person is suddenly called, or you know, being a bearer of the Dhamma, this involves or this includes practicing in accordance with the correct method of satna practice. And this satna then means that we have to be a practitioner and a bearer of satna, the Dhamma. Secondly, we are a person who has realized satna, the Dhamma. And thirdly, a person who has who puts the Dhamma to good practice. Such a person is known as a bearer of the Dhamma.
Jitangzu suraga kuna sasavinga pyogereta. Jitangzu saita pribhichante suravare. Jujadi atai. Magarunara saita vira yasavya nyanone. Jujadi atai jitangzu lu. Jinnima lera vira jitangzu lu. Tiro teve tirijaja kovavare. ဒီတော့ကျင်းလေးမှာလေ့လာရုံသိအောင်နဲ့မပြီးဘူးလက်တွေ့ကျင့်ရတယ်လက်တွေ့ကျင့်မှကျင့်ရတဲ့ကျူတွေရနိုင်တယ်အဲ့ဒါမှသူပိုင်နေဆိုတော့အတိပ္ပယ်တွေလည်းပဲအကုန်လုံးဒီထဲမှာပါသွားပါတယ်ဥပမာပြရောဂါဖြစ်လို့ဆေးကုခံတယ်ဆိုရင်စိတ်ချရတဲ့ဆရာဟောတာကျင့်ကပ်ပြီးတော့ကိုယ်ဖြစ်တဲ့အကြောင်းအရာတွေပြောပြတာဒီတော့ကျွမ်းကျင်တဲ့ဆရာဟောကယောဂအမြင့်ရင်းနေကြည့်ပြီးတော့ ตัวเนี่ยตื่นต่อได้เสียไปอ่ะครับเบลเดเสียโหญเนี่ยไอ้ตัวก็ซ่าอ่ะนะญูนี่ไม่ดีเว้ยแต่เสียยันซ่าลงไม่ผิดหรอกอืมจ้อยเจินเนี่ยเสียโหญญูจ้ะได้ไอ้ตัวเสียหนีไว้อ่ะครับแต่ดาหลุนายะกฤษสาครับหลุนายะตาออกมั้ยซ่าหิงสีบะเหลียวซ่าลงสิยโยคะฮะทีนี้ไปสุขก็ได้นะครับ ဒါအစားတဲ့အကျိုးပဲတမ။ယောဂါကြီးကင်းပြီးတော့ကျမ်းပါလာတဲ့အကျိုးပဲ။ပြီးတော့ကျမ်းပါတဲ့အကုန်အားရှိတဲ့အကုန်ဒါတွေလည်းပဲကိုယ်ပိုင်သွားတော့တာပါပဲ။အဲ့ဒီသဘောမျိုးပါပဲတမ။ဟောတာဟောထားပြီးတော့ဟောတဲ့တိုင်မကျင့်ပဲနဲ့ဒီတိုင်းပဲရှင်းစာရုပ်နေမယ်ဆင်းညွတ်ရုပ်နေမယ်ဆိုတော့ရုပ်ဦးနဲ့မရဘူးဆိုတဲ့အဓိပ္ပာယ်မျိုးပါပဲတမ။ ဥရမြတ်စွာကနိဗ္ဗိထားတဲ့အတိုင်းကိုလက်တွေ့ကြကြနီးတည်ပြီးတော့ပြည့်စုံကျင့်တတ်လို့တဲ့ဒီညွန်တဲ့အတိုင်းကျင့်သုံးမှကျင့်သုံးရင်ကျင့်သုံးတော့ရမှာပဲရတဲ့တရားဒါကိုပိုင်တာပဲခုနကလူနာလိုပဲဒါပဲစေစာဖတ်ယုံနေရှားဝွန်ညွှန်ကြားယုံနေနားထောင်ယုံနေတော့မပြီးဘူးဆိုတော့ဒါဆိုလိုပါတယ်
Now, as mentioned earlier on, one needs to be a practitioner. And one needs to practice as following the instructions given by the Buddha out of great compassion, Maha Karuna. So just studying the Dhamma will, and without actually putting it into practice, will not be sufficient. This would be tantamount to a person suffering from a disease, then consulting a doctor, a physician, the doctor who is a skilled doctor, then prescribes a certain medicine to cure this disease, and then it is the task of the patient to take that medicine. And the patient has to take the full course of the medicine, and certainly with this satna, then eventually the disease will subside, the patient will be free from the disease. The result of this then is that one regains one's health, one becomes a possessor of health and a possessor of fitness strength. So along that same line, the Buddha has taught the Dhamma, and so if one were not to practice it, then it would be like a patient who is certainly not taking the medicine as instructed by the physician.
So it's
So one has to practice in accordance to the Buddha's satna teachings. Then only does one become a possessor of fatna dhamma. So this is then to be seen in accordance with the illustration, the example given earlier on. So not practicing the Dhamma after having heard it, studied it, will not be sufficient. Now, as Satna stated early on in the Pali, such a practitioner has to practice in accordance with the instructions, in accordance with the right or correct Satna method of meditation, and Satna this, and as much as Satna one practices effectively. One needs to practice effectively, and Sapna eventually will gain a special Dhamma. And then one has to apply this. Now, in this connection, one needs to ask oneself, one needs to know what are the special results of the practice. And do I really have securely gained positive results? Am I a possessor of these special benefits? It is good to ask oneself these kind of questions.
ကျင်းနီးမှန်လေ့လာခြင်းနေ့ကျင့်ဆောင်ခြင်းထိအောင်ကျင့်ဆောင်ခြင်းပေါ့လေသုံးတရားဥရရှိခြင်းလေးရရှိတဲ့တရားကိုအသုံးချနိုင်ခြင်းအဲ့ဒါဟာဓမ္မကျင့်ဆောင်သူလို့ဆိုရပါတယ်ဓမ္မ
Therefore, the practice of footnote of the Dhamma includes four points. Number one, the study of the Dhamma. Number two, the practice of the Dhamma. Number three, realization of footnote of the Dhamma. And number four, putting into practice the application of what has been gained. A person who fulfills these points can be referred to as a practitioner and a bearer of the Dhamma.
ไอ้ที่ลูกเจี๊ยสอนเนี่ยปู่กูก็ธรรมะก็สร้างมาทาจริงสร้างชอบขึ้นกาไว้จริงอสิ้นตันหมิ่นติไปจริงဆိုတာบาแล้วဆိုတာလဲဒါလဲလိုပါတယ်ไอ้ဒီအိဗယ်မပြောခင်လူတွေဆိုတာချမ်းသာချစ်ချတာပဲကျေတုကဆိုတာဘုရားမကြိုက်ဘူးကိုချမ်းသာခြင်းလို့ရှိရင်ကိုကိုကို မမရအောင်ထိမို့လို့ပါတယ်ကိုလက်စက်တဲ့အကျင့်ဆိုးနှုတ်နဲ့စက်တဲ့အကျင့်ဆိုးနဲ့စိတ်နဲ့စက်တဲ့အကျင့်ဆိုးပါတယ်ကိုလက်စက်တဲ့အကျင့်ဆိုးကတော့တမ်းဟုတ်ခုံးကာမတောင်းကြမှုနှုတ်နဲ့စက်တဲ့အကျင့်ဆိုးကတော့လိန်မှုရန်တိုက်မှုစေတိုင်းထွားမကြောက်မနာသာပြောဆုံးအနှစ်မဲ့တဲ့စကားတွေအချင်းကုန်ကပြောဆုံးရေးတာမှု တာနှုတ်နဲ့စတဲ့အကျင့်ဆိုးတွေစိတ်နဲ့စတဲ့အကျင့်ဆိုးကတော့သူတို့ဘာပြည်စီအပိုင်းမတရားရလို့မှုသူများဖြစ်စီလို့မှုကောင်းတာပြုလဲကောင်းကျိုးမရဆိုးတာပြုလဲဆိုးမရတည်ရင်ပြီးတာပဲဆိုတယ်လူအယူဆပါလဲစိတ်နဲ့စတဲ့အယူဆအဲ့ဒီတရားတွေကိုတော့ဘုရားမြတ်ဆိုကဒုစရိတကျင့်ဆိုးတယ်လို့ပြောတော့ပါတယ်ကျင့်ဆိုးတွေကိုကျင့်ဆိုးမှသိပြီးတော့ရှောင်ရမယ် မရှောင်နိုင်ရင်အောက်တန်းကြတဲ့အလုပ်တွေလုပ်တော့မရှောင်နိုင်သူအောက်တန်းကြတော့တာပဲရှောင်နိုင်ရင်ရှောင်နိုင်သလိုအစင်တန်းမြင့်လာတာပဲဒါပဲဒီရှောင်သိနေတဲ့ဟာဒီရှောင်လို့ရှိရင်ကိုယ်မှာလည်းပဲအကျင့်ကောင်းနေရရှိပြီးတော့သူတော်ဘာကိုလည်းပဲကိုယ်စီစီအောင်ပြုမူရစောရအောင်ရောက်တော့ကိုကိုကို မမရအောင်ထိ ंछ ုပ်ချင်းဖြင့်သူတော်ဘာကိုလည်းပဲကာဝယ်ဆောက်ရှောက်ပြီးသားဖြစ်သွားတယ်လူသားချင်းဆိုတာကကိုကြီးစတဲ့တရားထားပြီးတော့သူတော်ဘာကိုမတိကြရအောင်ကာဝယ်ဆောက်ရှောက်အောင်ကိုကြီးစတဲ့တရားနဲ့သူတော်ဘာကာဝယ်ဆောက်ရှောက်ချင်းဖြင့်ကိုကိုကိုလည်းပဲမမရအောင်အလိုလိုထိ ंछ ုပ်ပြီးသားဖြစ်သွားတယ်အဲ့လိုအမှားကိုရှောင်ရှားပြီးတော့အမှန်တွေကိုလွတ်ဖို့ရတယ်မြတ်စွာဘုရားအတူချုပ်ပြီးတ ဒီတော့ရှောင်းနေနေဆောင်းနေနေမတည်သေးဘူးဆိုလို့ရှိရင်ဒါအစင်တမ်းမြင့်တက်လာတာပဲအဲ့ဒါကျင့်သုံးတဲ့အပိုင်းနေမဟုတ်သေးဘူးပေပုံပဲပြီးကျင့်သုံးရမယ်ဆိုတော့နီးလေးတည်တာနဲ့ပဲနီးမသေးခင်အောက်တန်းကြတယ်နီးတည်သွားတဲ့ခါကျတော့ဒီမှာတိမှုဖြစ်လာတော့အစင်တမ်းမြင့်တက်လာကြည့်ပေါ့ဒါကျင့်သုံးရတဲ့အပိုင်းမြောက်သေးဘူးအဲ့ဒါဓမ္မရဲ့အတိတ်ပဲ
Now, as Sutton explained, a bearer of Futna, the Dhamma, will be aided, will be protected, will be uplifted. Now, before going into the details of Futna, this the Venerable Sayadaw needs to explain a further point. Namely, all beings prefer happiness over unhappiness. if we wish for happiness, desired happiness, then we have to avoid the three forms of misconduct. Number one, to avoid forms of misconduct related to the body, such as engaging in activities as taking of life, taking what is not given, and indulging in unlawful sexual relations. We have to further avoid or refrain from unskillful practices such as verbal misconduct, namely engaging in wrongful speech, in slandering and backbiting, harsh speech, and indulging in gossip, meaningless talk. So these are four forms of verbal misconduct. Then we have three forms of mental misconduct coming in the form of covetousness, namely very much coveting others' property, wanting to harm others, and lastly, holding wrong views, such as wholesome deed will lead to unwholesome results, and performing an unwholesome deed will lead to wholesome results. And if I die, well, that's fine. Now, the Buddha called these forms of misconduct by body, speech, and mind ducharita in the Pali scriptural language. And these forms of misconduct we have to avoid. Now, if we will not avoid the various forms of misconduct, then we will decline. Now, as much as we are able to avoid the forms of misconduct as stated, we will be uplifted. And as a result of this, or in this certain context, we will not insult others and also not bring harm to ourselves. And thus we will be protected. Out of compassion, we will not want to harm or hurt others, and in this way too, we protect ourselves. Now, this is what the Buddha has stated or given in short, and the Venerable Sayadaw wanted to make this certain point clear before going any further. If we do not know how to avoid misconduct, then a decline will take place. If we do know how to avoid misconduct, then this will mean that our status will be uplifted. Now, in this context, we need to know the correct method. If we already know the correct method, then this is already one first step towards an upliftment. In particular, when we consider this against not knowing the correct method that leads to an upliftment. This is the meaning of Dhamma.
So, Javazo, goodness that the Jesu told you that Tamu called Jesu the Kuvali. Dosa Pila, look, you have Tabu Jonah, we saw you. Dosa Aleo body. Talaje, so you, the Lucian to Kupieto. ตุรบาก็เลยไปกุศิชี้อย่างปิ๊ดอย่างยောက်ตาเตตุเตียวได้หมดตุเตียวไอ้ไต้หวันนี่เลยไปอกลงฉอกช้ากันนะเว้ยตะมาดาก็ตุนยะตัดเนี่ยด้วยกูไปโลกนี้เลยเป็ดสีพี่แล้ววุ่นจิ๋นก็เลยไปฉอกช้าออกไปลุเตะตัวบาเว้ยตะมุสุดาดาหลุดั้นชาวมาเว้ยลุจิ๋นก็เป็ดหลุดั้นจิ๋นมาเว้ยสุดาจิ๋นเนี่ยด้วย มีมีเลยเว้ยกูสิงเจ๋เลยตุรบาเลยเว้ยสอกายะไม่หยอกพูสุดาบ่นี่บัวเสร็จๆเลยเว้ยหลุก้องเดียวอนิเนี่ยผิดตัวไหนเลยสุดาบ่นี่อโจลิดิตีทาတော့เปล่าเว้ยดอดาผิดๆตีขันพี่တော့ตําหมู่ช่องเลยเลยสอเยกูจิ๋นหลุจิ๋นโหเลยไม่เป็ดတော့วุ่นจิ๋นโลกะนี้โหเลยเว้ย ညီတဲ့အောင်ပြုလို့ရရောက်တာပဲသူတို့ဘာလည်းပဲစောကရောက်တာပဲအဲဒီလိုအကျိုးပြည့်တွေကိုတည်ပြီးတော့ရှောင်းတဲ့နီးနဲ့ဆောင်းတဲ့နီးတိုင်းပေါ်လေကျင့်သုံးလို့ရှိရင်ကျင့်သုံးသူဟာအဲဒီကျင့်သုံးတဲ့တရားကပေါတမကြရအောင်ဟိတိပြလိုက်တာပဲအဲဒါဓမ္မအတိတ်ပဲကျန်တဲ့ခိုးမှုကာမတောင်းရမှုဆိုတာလည်းဒီတိုင်းမှာပဲရတယ်
Out of the physical, out of the three physical transgressions, let us take the case of taking life, namely killing. A person who gives in to hatred, anger, dosa in the Pali scriptural language, will perform an act of killing. And with this, this person will destroy his or her human responsibility or duty, certain task. And not only that an act of killing means the death of a person, but it means also bringing harm to the family of the person who's been killed. And thus it brings about a disturbance in the world, in that particular community. Everybody has the responsibility to avoid this kind of an act of physical transgression. Once we understand the benefits of refraining, of avoiding bodily transgression such as the taking of life, then we will be patient when anger suddenly arises, and we will not act on it. With this, our world in which we live, our immediate world, will remain peaceful. So when we know the method of how to avoid transgressions and the method to observe what should be observed, then this will bring about an upliftment. And this is what is known as Dhamma. The same thing then applies also to the act, physical transgression of stealing and indulging in sexual misconduct.
Dari ra seza me so lo chi ye dari ti saung sara ha saung pi lo ma tin tha da be saung ma tha da be dhamma hi ragati dhamma cha ni so le tai ma ကာဝယ်သူစောက်ရှောက်သူချိမြောက်သူအစင်တန်းမြင့်တင်ပေးသူအဲတမှုကျွလုံးနဲ့ပုဂ္ဂိုလ်ကဒါလူစင်တန်းနဲ့ကြတော့တာပဲကိုကြည့်အောင်မပြည့်အောင်ကိုရင်းစံတရားနဲ့ထိန်းလို့ရှိရင်အဲ့ဒီအသိရှိပြီးတော့ထိန်းသိမ်းမှုစောက်ရှောက်မှုကအဲ့ဒီထိန်းသိမ်းတဲ့ပုဂ္ဂိုလ်ကိုကုပြောသလိုစောင့်မဆောက်ရှောက်ကာဝယ်ကုညီအစင်တန်းမြင့်တင်ပေးတာပဲဒါပဲ
No, the Venerable Sayadaw has quoted a text or a short passage in Pali, which is meaning, or the meaning of which is the Dhamma carries or bears the practitioner who practices in accordance with the Dhamma. However, what is important here is that this statement applies only to those who are actually practicing. So, in other words, the Dhamma, if we follow it and certainly apply it, will help us. And the Dhamma will also look after us. It will take care of us. It will protect us and uplift us. Now, in the case of a murderer, his or her standard of life will surely decline. Now, we need to have this knowledge, and as a person who then controls himself or herself, we will be uplifted. We will be aided by the Dhamma. We will be protected. And it's important to clearly understand this meaning.
A good Cynthia, Gown of Gomer, Delight Bizonado, Davenet, she can love with Gowny Rather. Gunen on a Juno so very, so you get Harry goes. ช่องไหนน่ะแล้วเว้ยดาวแล้วเว้ยชีดีเลยตัวတော့ตลอดดาปี้ก็ปี้ซ้อมมาฉีกันป้ายอ่ะไม่ตัวหรอกฉีกันไม่ป้าเว้ยเนี่ยတော့สิทธิ์นี่สิทธิ์ทั้งเนี่ยอติญญาณนี่ผิดป้อมไม่ลงไหนบ่ฉีกันฉีกูฉีอ่ะไม่ตัวหรอกหลูแลหลูไล่เนซงกาบาติก็ปี้ซ้อมมาเยหันแลเยหันไล่ยานี่เจตัวมาไม่ไตขะพุทธิเจตัวมาไม่ดาดา ဒီအချင်းလောက်ကြီးအခြေခံပဲဒါရှိသေးတယ်အဲ့တော့စိတ်နဲ့စိတ်ထားတွေကိုမထိမ့်သိမ်းမဲ့နဲ့တိုင်းပြစ်ထားလို့ရှိရင်စိတ်ဆိုတော့တောင်ရောက်မြောက်နဲ့ရောက်တတ်တာပဲတောပါပြီးဆက်ရှိတဲ့ချက်ချင်းဖြစ်တာပဲတောသားပြီးဆက်ရှိတဲ့ဖြစ်တာပဲမောဟကတော့အများဆုံးပါနေတာပဲလောဘလောကဖြစ်တဲ့အခါကျတော့ဒီရပြီးပစ္စည်းအပိုင်စီးခြင်းနော် ဒီတော့မိစ္ဆာစရာကာမတောင်းကြခြင်းနော်ကိုကြိုးငယ်ပြီးတော့လိန်တာဒါတွေဖြစ်နေတာပဲလိန်ခြင်းနဲ့စိတ်တွေပါလေဒေါသတွေလွန်ခဲ့လာပြီဆိုလို့ရှိရင်သူများတတ်ချက်ဖြစ်ခြင်းတာတတ်တာဒီနာလို့စိတ်ဝင်တို့စိတ်တွေများပြီးတော့သူများတက်တက်ဖြစ်စီတာဒေါသတွေလွန်ခဲ့ပြီးတော့လိန်တာညာတာလှဲ့တာမသိနားမလည်မှုရှိတော့အကျိုးရှိပြီးစီတင့်မတင့်ဖြစ်နိုင်တဲ့အတိညာမရှိတော့ဘူးရေးစီပါမလို့ပဲနဲ့သုံးနာပါ tari chit twa nai na ba da ma di lo sait klei de ma sait ma a phit bo do ni de de ko ma osa ta ne pye song ne a sa sa ri shi da lo chi yin a ga shi ni lo apu da e da pin man da wo twan nan nai da a ma shi apu da e da le ma twan nan nai wo pin man nan le ma khan nai wo da ba sait ma le ba di tai ba
Now, with this much, we will be endowed with virtue, sila. This is good. However, to be only avoiding transgressions and observing what should be observed, this is important as a foundation. And we do need to have a good foundation. Now, as a lay practitioner, we will have to observe our lay precepts. And as a monastic, we have to observe and live by our monastic vows. However, if we let the mind freely roam about, then when encountering greed, loba, or ill will, dosa, or encountering delusion, moha, then we may still want to engage or pursue an essential desire. We may still want to, when ill will is in excess, we may want to take life. We might want to take what is not given and indulge in intoxicants. So the mind sadness still needs to be strengthened. Just like the body needs to be strengthened. Without mental strength, we cannot withstand various vicissitudes. So there's a need to possess mental resistance power as well as resilience sadhana power.
Dira sait ko thain chauk de ni ko ro myat swa phaya ga samatha ni ne upassana ni na ni ho tha ga ba de samatha ni de so da ga ro ayu tuk khu de ma sait pi lo eti sait ka le taung yauk ma yauk ya aw paw le ba ปัวณีดาบ่นี่เมตตาปัวดาမျိုးกรุณาปัวดาမျိုးมุทิตาปัวดาမျိုးบ่นี่ธรรมดาမျိုးนี่บ่อืมเอ้าမျိုးတော့ธรรมดานี่ขอပါတယ်กูตริปิฏาณีก็โกได้ใส่ပြီးတော့ဖြည့်တိုင်းမှရှိตริပြုစောင့်ဆင်ထားဆိုတော့ဘောလေပင်တိုင်းအာယုတို့ခုခုပြုတ်ပြီးတော့ဘောလေအဲ့ဒါလေးကိုဆွဲမဲ့စွာတတိထားနေတာဘောလေဓမ္မဒါတတိရှိနေတာပါပဲအဲ့တော့လုတ်ပါများလို့ အယုံမှာစိတ်ကလေးကကပ်ပြီးတော့စိတ်ကြနိုင်သလောက်အဲ့ဒီခိုက်တမှာတချင်ဖြတ်ချင်းဒီမျိုးပစ္စည်းပိုင်စီချင်းအဲတချင်ဖြတ်မရှိတော့ဘူးဒီမျိုးပစ္စည်းပိုင်စီချင်းတော့ကာမတောင်းကြနေတာတော့လေဒါလေးဖြစ်ခွင့်မရဘူးဒါလေးအဲ့ဒါလေးအကုန်လုံးငြိမ်းနေပါတယ်တမအဲအဲ့ဒါလေးအလေးကြီးရသွားပြီဆိုလို့ရှိရင်ဒီ လောဘလွန်ကဲလို့သူများကိုစော်ကားတာမျိုးဒေါသတွေလွန်ကဲလို့သူများအတည့်ရဲ့စော်ကားတာမျိုးမရှိတော့ဘူးစိတ်ကိုနိုင်သွားပြီစိတ်တည်းဖြစ်နေတဲ့ကိလေသာတွေကိုတတိနဲ့ကြိုကာဝဲတာဘူးဖြစ်လာလို့ရှိရင်ချက်ချင်းရှုမှပြီးတော့ပယ်လိုက်တာပါလေဒီမှာမဖြစ်ခင်ကြိုရင်ကာဝဲရမယ်ဖြစ်လာလို့ရှိရင်ချက်ချင်းရှင်းပြရမယ်ကာဝဲရေးကုစားရေးနည်းတဲ့မြတ်စွာဘုရားဟောထားတယ်ပါတယ်ဒီမှာ
The Buddha has given two methods of controlling the mind. Those two ways are, number one, samatha, which means that we focus on one subject, one and single subject of meditation. This then would involve practices such as metta, bhavana, so the mental development through loving kindness, through meditation of compassion, karuna. The second approach is that of vipassana, meditation in accordance with the basic maxim of observing whatever predominant object arises at the sense doors, guarding the mind with vigilance, mindfulness at every time of arising, and using one primary object as the anchor. Now, when the mind sinks into an object of observation, then it will no longer want to take life. It will no longer want to possess others' property, and therefore, out of excessive greed, we will no longer insult others. And out of excessive ill will, dosa, we will no longer insult or harm others. Now, in this context, mindfulness, sati in the Pali scriptural language, performs two functions, namely as a prevention, preventing unwholesome states from mental states from arising, and if on occasion an unwholesome mental state has arisen, then it's the same mindfulness that will serve as the cure. So the Buddha has taught two things, namely prevention as well as cure through mindfulness.
မိကိုမလောင်ငင်းကကျူရင်းကာဝေးခြင်းဖြင့်အနိုင်ယူပါတဲ့လောင်းလာရင်ချက်ချင်းငိမ့်တတ်ပါတဲ့အဲ့ဒီဆိုဆိုရတဲ့နေ့ကိုက်ပါတယ်ယောဂမဖြစ်ခင်ကျူရင်းကာဝေးပါတဲ့ဖြစ်လာရင်ချက်ချင်းကုသပါဆိုတဲ့စကားနဲ့လည်းကိုက်ပါတယ်ဒါကိုယ်နဲ့စတဲ့ဟာတဲ့စိတ်နဲ့စတဲ့ဟာတွေကတော့ကိုယ်ထဲမှာတတ်မဲ့တဲ့ယောဂမိ ติเปสิโซมงคลเนี่ยดอดามีเนี่ยไม่แม้เนี่ยโมหะมีสรมีตรงมีสิบาระธรรมะเอ้ยมีตรงมีโกอะกูโตตริถาพี่တော့กาเวจิ้มขึ้นบ่เลยกาเวยะบาระตนเอามิตรปัวรามิโยบ่เลยตริถาบาวนาปัวรามิโยบ่เลยดิกาเวยะบาระดิเปรุกาเวยะได้เลยสรแล้วพ่อนี่ธรรมอฉิงโตโตเล่บ่ได้มาหู ဒီကဝေရတယ်ကာဝေနည်းတဲ့ကြားတဲ့ကသူတို့ကရကတော်သားမောဟတွေဖြစ်လာလို့ချင်းဘာလုပ်မလဲဆိုတော့ကုစားပြရတာပဲတင့်တော်တဲ့စီပြီးဝဲပြီးတော့ကုစားပြရတာပဲဒါကလည်းပဲရှုမှတ်ပြီးတော့ပြပြရတာပဲတမန်တော်ကာဝေရနည်းကုစားတဲ့နည်းမြတ်စွာဘုရားကအပြည့်စုံဟောခဲ့ပါတယ်တမန်အဲ့ဒါအသုံးချလို့ရှိရင်တမှုဘုံအစရှိတဲ့အားတွေလည်းပဲ
Now, in terms of worldly language, there is a saying that first one should prevent a fire from taking place, So prevention is certainly emphasized. However, when a fire has broken out, then, or when a fire has started, then immediately to extinguish it. The same thing also applies to a disease. So first, there's prevention of contracting a disease. And if, despite of this prevention, the disease does affect one, then to immediately go for a cure. So this certainly concerns certainly the body. Now with regard to the mind, the approach is certainly similar. Namely, that certainly we prevent as well as certainly cure the three fires. Namely, the fire of greed, the fire of ill will or anger, dosa, and certainly the fire of delusion. Now, in order to extinguish these satna fires, one could, for instance, develop loving kindness, metta. However, the Venerable Sayadaw will not have the time to explain exactly how to prevent or how to protect oneself through loving kindness. The Buddha has certainly given us the way to protect, or a way of protection, and a way of certain cure. A way of protection and certain cure with regard to act, or with this, then cases such as taking life, killing, and stealing will surely become rather insignificant, rather small. Now, what has been explained can be summed up under the term samadhi, sikha in the Pali scriptural language, which means training in concentration. With this, our standard will be quite improved or uplifted. Oh, and one needs to protect oneself through satipatthana, namely the establishments of mindfulness. Now, when we lack when we lack mindfulness, satipatthana, then we might transgress. And this may lead to our downfall. This could be compared to parents losing control over their teachers. But if, on the other hand, parents and teachers do have a good control over their children and focus not only on the development of the IQ intelligence quotient, then the life of such Ka-Nying kids will be greatly improved. And because parents and teachers do exercise a control over their children, because of this, their status, their standard will be uplifted. And so this happens because parents and teachers have a certain knowledge from which they are working. This then implies that such children are not only human beings, but even better, they become distinct human beings. And this satna then is another form of upliftment. This shows how the Dhamma is satna uplifting.
ဒီအရှင်လောက်ဆိုရင်တော့တော်တော်မြင့်တဲ့တော့ဒါမှမဟုတ်အရှင်အမြင့်ဆုံးအရှင်ရောက်ပြီလို့တော့ဒီလိုတော့တွေ့လို့တော့မရဘူးနှစ်ဖြာရောက်ကကုသတဲ့ပုဂ္ဂိုလ်ဟာအဖျားကတရားလေးတရားချောက်တဲ့နေပြီဆိုရင်ဖျားကြီးချောက်ကိုကျူးစားတယ်တဖြာကြပြမှန်သွားပြီဒါမှမဟုတ်နှစ်ချက်သုံးချက်တော့ဖျားနေသေးတယ် ဖျားမျိုးမပြတ်သေးဘူးဒီတက်ပြတ်ကြပြမှန်သွားလို့ရှိရင်တော့မတည်တော့ဘူးဆိုတော့တာတည်ကြပါလေအဖျားမျိုးပြတ်အောင်ဖျားပြတ်စီစားဖို့လိုပါတယ်ဆောင်းနေရာပြောတာတော့အဖျားပို့သေးအောင်ပေါ့လေဒီမှာဘုန်းကြီးတို့ကတော့အဖျားမျိုးပြတ်အောင်ပေါ့လေမျိုးပြတ်အောင်ဗီဇပြတ်အောင်အဲ့တော့အဖျားမျိုးပြတ်အောင်ဖျားပြတ်စီစားလို့သူ တက်တက်ချိန်မှာမတက်တော့ဘူးဆိုလို့ရှိရင်တော့ဘုရားပြုပြီးပြီးတော့ဘုရားယောဂါတော့ကြာသွားပြီဘုရားမျိုးပြတ်ဖို့တဆင့်လိုနေတည်းဆိုတော့ထို့အတူပဲစိတ်တည်းပြနေတဲ့ကိလေသာတွေတော့ညှိတတ်တဲ့နီးကာဝရဏီကုစားတဲ့နီးတော့ရှိနေပြီဒါတော့အကြောင်းရင်းရလို့ရှိရင်ဖြစ်ခွင့်ရှိတဲ့မျိုးပြတ်ဖို့ရတော့ဆက်ရပါသေးတယ်ဓမ္မ
Now, this state that has been described so far is of a pretty high standard. However, with this we have not yet reached the highest level. To give an illustration in this context, when a person comes down with malaria and is running a high temperature every day, then first of all, the temperature has to be reduced. And if this is done, then gradually the malaria will, these high fever periods will occur only every 2 or 3 days. However, with this, the malaria bacteria have not been cut off as sudden yet. So one then has to take the respective malaria medication in order to fully eradicate the underlying malaria bacteria. The same thing applies certainly in the world of Dhamma. As long as unwholesome mental states arise, then we are not, we cannot certainly say that these mental defilements have been totally eradicated. So we need to go beyond prevention and cure. In other words, those mental defilements will have to be fully eradicated or cut off. And this is the work of Panya, namely wisdom. And this wisdom then consists of two aspects, namely vipassana panya, so vipassana wisdom, and secondly, noble wisdom, ariya panya, in the Pali scriptural language. It is in this way that certainly we have to cut off or eradicate the underlying defilements. If we do not certainly do this, or do not succeed in doing this, then the notion of an individual self, jiwata in the Pali scriptural language, will remain. And certainly the notion of a mahaparamatta will also remain. And so we will be holding on to these notions. We will then take that jiva-atta to be permanent, and we will also take the mahaparamatta to be equally permanent and certainly the center, the main center, like the headquarters. The jiva-atta is certainly perceived to be as the one which takes the orders from Mahabrahma. So we will take both of these, the individual self or soul and the Mahabrahma, Brahma Atta, as real. We will think these are permanent, and with this then there will be a clinging to the notion of a self. Now, in Satipatthana practice, when we observe the predominant objects, we will come to know in a clear-cut manner that the arising of mental phenomena and physical phenomena, nama and rupa phenomena, and that there is nothing apart from those. We will further discern how those physical and mental formations are related by cause and effect. With this understanding, the notion of a creator, of a Mahabrahma Atta, will fall away. Now, upon seeing how physical and mental formations are related by cause and effect, we will then go on to see the arising of formations and also how those formations pass away. Seeing that formations are arising and passing then will lead us to an understanding of the unsatisfactory nature of formations, and further will come an understanding of the nature of anatta, namely that formations are not identical with a self. So step by step, our knowledge will mature until eventually we will gain that state or that element of fatna peace, and a state where we go from pavata to abhavata, namely from a state of revolving around a certain cycle to a state of no more revolving. And it is with noble path knowledge and fruition knowledge that we come to know that peaceful element.
ဒီတော့တကယ်အရှိအမှန်တရားတွေကိုဘယ်ဘုံဝင်ပြီးအောင်တော့ရတယ်ဆိုတော့ကျင်းနေမှလေ့လာခြင်းတတရားရှိဆောင်လို့ပဲဒီတဲ့အတိုင်းကျင့်သုံးတော့ယုံနာပိဿာတိမောအစအတိညာနေဖြစ်ပြီးတော့နောက်ဆုံးအပုတ္တခေါ်တဲ့တကယ်ချမ်းသာကိုဘာဖြစ်တော့ရရှိခြင်း နိမန္တိတဲ့နိမတိတဲ့တိုင်းနမကြအောင်ရှင်းတယ်အဲ့ဒါတွေရရှိတယ်အမဂ္ဂရရှိတဲ့ချမ်းသာတွေရရှိတယ်အဲ့ဒီရရှိတဲ့ဆရာရဲ့ချမ်းသာကိုပိုင်လာပဲအဲ့ဒါကိုဒီတရားကျင့်ဆောင်သူတို့ခေါ်တယ်လို့ကျင့်ဆောင်တဲ့ဓမ္မကလည်းပဲအဲ့လိုကျင့်ဆောင်တဲ့ပုဂ္ဂိုလ်ကိုဆုံးမပေးထားတယ်အောက်တန်းကြရအောင် ဟုတ်တန်းကြတဲ့ဘัวစုတွေမြောက်ရအောင်ပြီးတော့တန်တရာမှာလည်းပဲဘัวတွေထက်ကထက်ကဖြစ်နေရတယ်လေမကြရအောင်ဟုတ်တန်းကြတဲ့ဘัวလေးမကြရအောင်တန်းကြတဲ့ဘัวလေးမကြရအောင်ဘဝတည်တည်ဖြစ်ဖြစ်နေရတယ်လေမကြရအောင်လေအဲ့ဒါကူညီထားတာပဲဒီကတော့ကြီးရှုထားတာပဲကာကွယ်ထားတာပဲစောက်ရှောက်ထားတာပဲ ချင်းမြောက်ထားတာပဲအကျုပ်ကတော့မြစ်တင်ပေးတာပဲဆိုတာပေါ့လေအဲ့ဒါဟာဓမ္မဆိုတာဘာလဲဆိုတဲ့အတိတ်ပဲပါပဲဒါပါပဲဘယ်လိုလဲဆိုတာကတော့အခုလိုအခုလိုပြတဲ့ဤတိုင်းလုံးလို့ရှိရင်သူရဲ့စွာရည်တတ္တိဖြစ်လာတော့ဒီလိုပဲဆိုတာဓမ္မကဒီလိုပဲဆိုတာလည်းပဲအဖြေရတော့ပါပြီ
Now, in order to understand reality as it certainly truly exists, we first of all, we have to study the correct method of practice. Secondly, we have to engage in the practice itself. And as number three, we have to realize the Dhamma. When these certain three points are fulfilled, or with the fulfillment of these three points, we become a possessor of the Dhamma, or in other words, a bearer of the Dhamma. The Dhamma then will uplift such a practitioner and bearer of the Dhamma, so that through practice, we no longer, our status no longer drops, so that there's no decline. In the course of samsara, it is in such a way that the Dhamma looks after us, takes care of us, prevents us from unwholesomeness, protects us, and uplifts us. This is the meaning of Dhamma. Now, how does this happen? And certainly, the Dhamma is certainly, the Dhamma is just, or is like this.
ဒီကေကျေလို့တဲ့ပုဂ္ဂိုလ်ကြီးကျင့်တဲ့အောင်ဆိုပြီးတော့ညဆောပြားကလေးကျင်တဲ့ငါးပါးပတ်လုံးကျင့်နိမန္တရားတွေဟောတာလားအဲ့ဒါတွေကိုပရိယတ်တိလို့ခေါ်ပါတယ်ပရိယတ်တိကကျွန်းတဲ့အတိုင်းကျင့်သုံးတာလက်တွေ့ကျင့်သုံးတာဟုတ်လက်တွေ့ကျင့်သုံးတာကိုပฏิပတ်တိလို့ခေါ်ပါတယ်အဲ့ဒီကျင့်သုံးတာတွေကတော့သီလရဲ့တမာရိရဲ့ပညာရဲ့ဒါပါပဲ ကျွလုံးစကားတဲ့ကိလေသာတွေမကျွလုံမရအောင်ကာဝယ်ကူစားပေတယ်မျိုးပြတဲ့ကိလေသာတွေကိုတော့မပြအောင်ကာဝယ်ကူစားပေတယ်မျိုးပြတဲ့ကိလေသာတွေကိုပဒနာပညာမဲ့ပညာနဲ့အပြတ်ရှင်းတယ်ဒါပါပဲအဲ့ဒါတော့ပฏิပတ်တိလို့ခေါ်ရတယ်တမန်အပြတ်ရှင်းတော့ဘာရလဲဆိုတော့
Now, when we really practice satna, the Dhamma as taught by the Buddha over a period of 45 years, then this Dhamma, these instructions, are known as pariyatti. Now, the actual practice of satna, the Dhamma, is known as patipatti in the Pali scriptural language. Pariyatti is the study of the Dhamma. Now, it is with virtue, with an ethical conduct, that we overcome and that we prevent transgressive defilements, or we prevent transgressive defilements from occurring. It is through concentration that we prevent certainly the obsessive defilements from acting, and it is certainly through wisdom that we might cut off the dormant or latent defilements. So it is with vipassana panya, namely vipassana wisdom and noble wisdom that those dormant mental defilements will be uprooted once and forever. Now, the steps involved then are pariyatti, the study of the Dhamma. Then we have patipatti as the practice of the Dhamma, and what we will gain is the realization of the Dhamma, patiweda. So pariyatti, patipatti, and patiweda. To put it differently, we have the training in virtue, sila, seka. We have the training in concentration, samadhi, seka, and there is also the training in wisdom, panya, seka. So we will be fulfilled or endowed with those three trainings.
Era magrunaro tabiranyano paisaine meso phyasin kuro myo kho thare kini ma priyati ne anyi ko le kin thong lo ko ma yashi de tilatamati pinya kin tiya re ne ni san kin thong ne pogo ko pali lo dhamma vihari lo kho ba de Kinimani Tiviro Kendolo Tiratika Matitika Pinatikari Paishim Body. Edina ni nine chini diogara and at the Mauya recovery.
So this is a Dhamma as discovered and taught by the Buddha himself out of great compassion, Makaruna, and out of omniscience, covering pariyatti, so the study of the Dhamma, and the practice of the Dhamma, eventually leading to the realization of the Dhamma. A person who knows the correct method of practice actually applies satna this, then is known as a Dhamma Vihari, namely someone, a bearer of satna the Dhamma.
Dhamma Vihari Poko Mesavyava Forget the word. Priyati Pahula Pani, Mesavia Water at Yarolego. Priyati Tete Pani, Tinjavu Miare Poku Leve Hota Vadido. Eta that Tinjavido, singing Yamachinka Pene Pani, Tilatwani Pina Chintiarego. Pizombo, Tintomo Hani the Poku Rivoli, Eta Priyati.
Now, when it comes to a Dhamma Vihari, a person, the Buddha has given further qualifications as to what such a Dhamma Vihari is. Now, a pariyatti bahula is a person who pursues only the study of the Dhamma, namely pariyatti, without going to a secluded place, without engaging in the practice. So such a person the Buddha referred to as pariyatti bahula person.
လေလာလို့တက်တလောက်တက်ပြီဆိုလို့ရှိရင်အဒီတက်တာလေးနဲ့ပညတ်တိပဟုလို့ဆိုတာပါလေတက်တာလေးနဲ့ကျင်းသားပြီးတော့တဆင့်ပုတ်ချပေးနေတာတဲ့အခုလိုဆင်ရကပ်ပြီးတော့တမောက်ရာတိဖြစ်အောင်မကြိုးစားကြဘူးတဲ့အဲဒီပုဂ္ဂိုလ်ကတော့ပညတ်တိပဟုလာပုဂ္ဂိုလ်လို့ဒီလိုလည်းခေါ်ထားပါတယ်
No. second Satna type of Satna person is one who has Satna studied the Bariyati to some extent, has learned some things, who then the Buddha refers to as a Panyati Bahula, who then goes on to teach others without without seeking a secluded Satna place, without trying to realize, without Satna practicing and trying to practice and realizing the Dhamma.
အဲ့ဒါကိုလေ့လာသင်ရပို့ချတာတဲ့တရားတော်တွေကိုဓမ္မတွေကိုပေါ့လေနေ့စဉ်အချိန်ယူပြီးတော့ရွတ်ဖတ်တဲ့ဆဲနေတာပေါ့လေအဲ့ဒါနဲ့အချိန်အများကြီးအသုံးချသူပေါ့လေသိညာကပ်ပြီးတော့အခုလိုတရားတွေအားထုတ်ပြီးတော့ဓမ္မဝိဟာရီပိုင်မရောက်နိုင်တဲ့ပုဂ္ဂိုလ်တွေကိုစัจချာရဘဟုလာလို့ခေါ်ရတယ်အဲ့ဒီပုဂ္ဂိုလ်တွေလည်းမြတ်စွာဘုရားကိုယ်တိုင်ခေါ်ထားခဲ့ပါတယ်
Now, the Buddha has mentioned yet another type, namely one who has studied, who then goes on to teach, and furthermore recites on a daily basis, using up a lot of time, rather than going to a secluded satna place and practicing. The Buddha has referred to such a person as Sacchaya Bahula.
Edilu lila thare damari go, chingon kamira lila thare damari go, dipoga badi be saune, diwaja ga badi be saune, anede be de goli, siza singe biro animya re pogo goli, singe ya kabiro.
Now then we have a person who was certainly much studied certainly the Dhamma, and certainly then reflects on the meaning of certainly the Dhamma by questioning what is Satna, the meaning of this paragraph, what is the meaning of this Satna sentence. And Satna who does Satna not seek a secluded place and practices. Such a person, the Buddha referred to as a Vitakka Bahula person.
ကျောင်းပြုပြီးတော့ပါလိဘိက္ခုတို့တဲ့ပုဂ္ဂိုလ်၄မျိုးကိုတော့ငါဟောငါမျိုးကိုတော့ဟောပြီးပြီတဲ့ဒီမှာတိကျတာကိုယ်ကိုကြလေ့လာပြီးတော့ပါလိဒါအကျိုးရှိစွာနဲ့သဘာဝတနာတရားစီအထောက်ကြတဲ့မမိမလျော့ကြနဲ့ရရှိတဲ့အချိန်လေးကိုအကျိုးရှိစွာနဲ့အသုံးချပြီးတော့ ကိုယ့်ဘဝကိုမြင့်တင်ရပါတဲ့ငါဖျားရဲ့တောင်းကတော့ပြီးပြီတဲ့အသင်တို့ဘက်ကတောင်းပဲရှိတော့တယ်အဲ့တော့ရှိဘဝကကံကောင်းလို့ရရှိရတဲ့ဘဝလေးကိုအမြတ်ထွေအောင်ကြိုးစားကြပါဆိုတာပေါ့လေအဲ့ဒါတို့တိုက်တွန်းပြီးတော့တရားအဆုံးသတ်ပါတယ်ဒီတော့အဲ့ဒီတရားတော်အရာအခုခေတ်ဘယ်လိုဖြစ်နေတယ်လဲဆိုတာကြည့်ဖို့ဘုန်းကြီးတို့မြန်မာပြည်လည်းပဲ Pinyati Bhula Pogori Shivara. Pinyati Bhula Pogori Shivara. Sejaya Bhula Pogori Shidra Shivara. Pira, the Pitikati and Nati Vere, Sinza Sinyana Pogori Shivara. The Mahushari level Shidra Shivara. The church nearly Kia Ragaro, the Mahushari, a set machine, a two round Shivido, Shivan Hari, Miani, the lady, two yards at the mark. Did a poet at the top yard at the Boga level, the care will go to your yard,
The Buddha then instructed the monks who had approached him by further saying, "O bhikkhus, I have taught you the Dhamma, and it's important that you study the Dhamma yourselves and then also practice it. Don't be negligent in this. Use your time wisely. If so, you will be uplifted. My task is fulfilled. Make good use of your time." The Venerable Sayadaw then added, "In Burma, there are, to some extent, people who could be referred to as pariyati bahulo, namely pursuing mostly the study of the practice. Likewise, in Burma, there are people who pursue the teaching of the study of the Dhamma. And then there are some who engage in the recitation of the Dhamma, Satya Bahula in Pali. And then there are also some who much reflect on the deeper meaning of the Dhamma." Now, in some places, there are people who abide in the Dhamma, bearers of the Dhamma, who are not genuine. Since we are related as Dhamma relatives, and as stated at the outset of this discussion, it is the Venerable Sayadaw's task to remind all of you to be genuine, to be or become genuine Dhamma talks, and with this become genuine Dhamma practitioners or bearers of the Dhamma. And with this, he would like to conclude his talk.
ကိုကြရတဲ့အချက်တွေကိုကျင်းလောက်အောင်အထုတ်ပါတယ်ဖွေရမေးတယ်ဘယ်လိုနေသလဲဆိုတာပါလေအခုမှစတာတောက်တာသွားတယ်ဒီလိုလည်းဖြေရရှိတယ်တချို့ကလည်းအခုမှနေရထိုင်တာသွားတယ်အခုမှသူတို့နေစရာအိမ်ရသွားတယ်ဘာမှပြည့်အကုန်ဆုံးထွက်ကုန်ဟာလက်တွေ့တတိပဒံဘာဝနာတရားပဲလို့ဒီလိုလည်းသူတို့ဖြေသွားပါတယ် မိဂတိတ်တာတချို့ကတော့သူတို့ဟာသိပ္ပပညာတွေထွန်းကားပြီးတော့သိပ္ပပညာနီးစနစ်နဲ့တည်ထွင်တဲ့ပစ္စည်းတွေကိုအထက်တန်းကြာကြာသုံးဆွဲပြီးတော့ပေါ့လေလူနည်းဘူးစင်တန်းမြင့်မြင့်နဲ့နေခဲ့တာတဲ့လေးအေးကန်းထဲမှာနှလုံးအပူမိတဲ့ဘုရားမျိုးပါပဲအခုမှလေးအေးကန်းထဲမှာနှလုံးအေးတဲ့နီးတွေရပါတယ်လို့ ဒီလိုသူတို့ဆိုကြတာပါပဲအဲ့ဒါသူတို့အနောက်နိုင်ငံသားတွေရဲ့တရားထုတ်ပြီးပြောဆိုတဲ့အချက်ကလေးတွေပါပဲကဲဘုရားတော်တမဓမ္မဆိုတာပါလဲပဲလို့လဲဓမ္မဝိဟာရီဟာဓာခေါ်ပါတယ်ဆိုတာပေါ့ဒီဝန်ခံတော်တဲ့အတိုင်းဟောပြောပြပါပြီဘုရားတို့လောကဆွေမျိုးသုံးတတ်ဓမ္မဆွေမျိုးနောက်ထပ်တစ်ထပ်ပေါ့လေဆွေမျိုးလေးတတ်တော်စက်တဲ့ပုဂ္ဂိုလ်များဘုရားစွန့်နိုင်နေများပါလေအခု အထုတ်တယ်နီးမပါဘူးတိုက်တွန်းချက်ပဲပါပါတယ်တိုက်တွန်းတဲ့အပါတဲ့အတိုင်းရရှိတဲ့အချိန်လေးကိုအသုံးချလို့ ဒီရွှေရှိတို့ကြံပါတော့စသရာဆီပြေတော့ပေါ့ဓမ္မဆိုတာပါလဲဆိုတာလက်တွေ့သိရအောင်လို့ဓမ္မဥပဒေအရင်ရောက်ရှိပြီးတော့မိမိရဲ့ဘဝအစဉ်တိုင်းအောင်ကြိုးစားအားထုတ်နိုင်ရပြီးတော့ပေါ့လေဘုန်းကြီးတို့တတူနေနဲ့ဓမ္မဆွေမျိုးအစ်တောစပ်ပြဇေလို့တိုက်တွန်းရတဲ့ဒီနေ့တရားဆုံးတာလေပါ
Now, the Venerable has taught widely and among the Europeans and Americans that he has asked about their meditation experiences. Here are some of the answers provided. Some retreatants have said, "It is only now that I have learned to eat, or it's only now that I have learned to go about life properly." Some have said, "It is only now that I have discovered my true home." And some have remarked that Satipatthana practice is Burma's best export article. Now, another remark was that the U.S. is clearly a country that has highly developed sciences. And this, even though this is certainly the case, one person remarked, "We feel, with a burning heart, we feel like being in an air-con room, an air-conditioned room. It is only now that we have received a proper method of Phutna practice." So the Venerable Sayadaw has explained this afternoon what is the Dhamma. He has further explained what is a Dhamma Vihari, so a bearer of the Dhamma. And the Venerable has spoken about us being related as loka relatives, so relatives in this world, that we are related by way of the Dhamma. Now, the Venerable Sayadaw has given you much, or has given you only encouragement, but not yet the actual practice. So make good use of your time, and he he's explained what the Dhamma is, and he would like to conclude by wishing, "May we become truly related as Dhamma relatives in the future." And this is it. Sadhu, sadhu, sadhu. Do you have any questions? Do we have time? So the Venerable Sayadaw has included already questions and the answers in his talk. So, if you have questions, then try to answer those questions yourselves.
So, on behalf of the Kathmandu branch of the Global Dharma Family. We wanted to thank Andrew for asking, for requesting this teaching to happen, and for the translator for allowing us to understand it. But most of all, we wanted to sincerely thank Venerable Sayadaw U for giving us this rare and very precious insight into a different tradition. And on behalf of all of us, I think I would like to say we hope you have a very long and happy life, and continue to teach the Dharma to all of us. And thank you very, very much. So,